In today's video, I'm going to talk about Maven, show how to create an app using an archetype and then build it. And finally, I will show how to do the same using Docker. So let's start. Maven is, among many things, a build automation tool which uses XML files called POM object model or POM files to describe different things about a project, like what dependencies the project has, how to build and deploy a project, and so on. So first, for using Maven locally without Docker, go to maven.apache.org and download Maven. Also, add it to the path so that it is easier to use it from the command line. Some helpful tips can be found at maven.apache.org/install. For dependency management, Maven uses two types of artifact repositories, which can be categorized as remote, which are typically publicly available on the internet like Maven Central, or privately available inside your company's internal network, and local repositories, which are typically inside an M2 folder inside your local file system where Maven runs, and it's used for caching and storing local builds. Artifact repositories store different types of dependencies like jar files or AEM packages. So typically, you would define the dependencies and versions of what your application requires on the POM file, like, for example, libraries for working with JSON, or in the case of AEM, libraries for managing Sling models, plugins for creating AEM packages, and so on. Then, we use the Maven command for building or creating an app. Maven will check your local repository, M2 folder, and look for the dependencies there first. If it doesn't find a dependency, it will automatically download it from the remote repository and also store it into the local one for future use, which will make the process even faster next time. Maven archetypes can be used for creating new applications or modules without going through the hassle of configuring each piece of the app by hand, like the appropriate libraries or the plugins required, the different profiles to execute, and many other different things needed to provide a seamless development experience. In our case, Adobe's archetype will take care of even creating some mock content, example classes, components, configurations, and other stuff for us so that we can start tinkering with our new app right away. I will follow the instructions from Adobe to create an app using Adobe's Archetype version 19. You can see those instructions at their site. If you scroll down, we can see the section called Create an Adobe CQ Archetype Project. There, you will find the parameters used and also the first part of the command that I'll be using. Just have in mind that the page is using the version 13th of the archetype. So let's create our first app example. When you execute the archetype, you will see that it will ask for a couple of parameters like the group ID, artifact ID, version, apps folder name, content folder name, and so on. I am also passing the parameters that the archetype will ask as part of the command. Once we confirm the values entered, and after a couple of seconds, our application is created inside the AEM first app folder. Adobe's archetype will generate a multi-module project. One for the bundle containing all the Java classes like Sling models and Sling servlets. One for the AEM package with the AEM components. Another one for the AEM package with the site and assets, and so on. With the generated application in place and our AEM author instance up and running, let's build and install our application. For that, let's open the AEM first up folder and head to the readme.md file and copy the instructions from there. We have a couple of options here, but I am going to focus on the one for building and installing our new application on an author instance. This command will use the default configurations for an AEM author instance located on your local host and using the standard 4502 port. I will also add the Adobe public profile here so that Maven looks for the archetype and other dependencies on Adobe's public repository. After a couple of minutes, we can see that it was hopefully successful. You can open AEM and check that the English page is working. Let's create the app and build it again, but this time let's use Docker instead. If you recall, last time we discussed that Maven uses a local.md folder for the local repository, and that whenever a dependency is missing there, it will try to download it from the remote repository. The issue here is that Docker containers are isolated from each other, and if we just try to execute the Maven commands, it will try to download everything every time you use a new container. To avoid that, I will use Docker volumes, which will allow us to define which local folder will be used for storing the artifacts downloaded by Maven so that they can be reused from different containers. For defining a volume, when starting a container, you just need to add a -v parameter followed by a mapping, in which you specify the local folder in which the files are or should be located, a colon, and the internal containers folder. We are going to use an already made Maven image on Docker Hub. I will be using some of the configurations already documented on this page. So again, let's try the app from scratch. Let's start with the command suggested on the Maven Docker Hub page, but let's for now use bash instead to explore the files. This one already has a volume configuration here. This means that the Docker container will be able to see the contents of this folder and also create more folders or files here. This container also needs that the work dir points to the same mapped internal folder, which is where Maven will run. I configured where my local.m2 repository is located so that the dependencies are stored there for later reuse. Finally, let's just append the rest of the command for using the archetype from before, but with the word Docker as a suffix. Given that there was no .m2 folder originally, it will start downloading everything from the internet. Midway through, it will ask me to confirm the parameters passed above, to which I will just hit enter. Finally, for building and installing the app, change into the first app Docker directory, copy the first lines for configuring the Maven container, change the .m2 volume configuration to point to the parent directory, and copy the same command used for building the app without Docker. Given that I am inside a Docker container, I will have to provide the IP for where my AEM instance is located. it will download all the other missing dependencies and will also take a lot of time to finish. Once that first pass is done, though, performing another build will take just a few minutes. You can open AEM and check that the English page is up. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you liked the video, please hit subscribe.